Welcome to two examples of matrix multiplication. We're given matrix C and D and asked to find each product if possible. When performing matrix multiplication, the order is extremely important because matrix multiplication is not commutative, meaning C times D does not equal D times C. So for C times D, matrix C must come first, which is a 2x2 matrix, and matrix D must come second, which is a 1x2 matrix. The first step in performing matrix multiplication is to check to see if the multiplication is even possible. In order for the multiplication to be possible, the number of columns in the first matrix must be equal to the number of rows in the second matrix. So to check this, notice that matrix C is a 2x2 matrix, and matrix D is a 1x2 matrix. So if these two values right here are not equal to each other, which they're not, then the matrix multiplication is not possible. And if it's not possible, we say the product is undefined. Now let's see if we can perform matrix D times matrix C. So in this case, matrix D is first, which is a 1x2 matrix, and matrix C is second, which is a 2x2 matrix. So we'll start by checking the dimensions. Again, this is a 1x2 matrix, and the second matrix is a 2x2 matrix. So because the number of columns in the first matrix equals the number of rows in the second matrix, the matrix multiplication is possible, and the dimensions of the product will be the number of rows in the first matrix by the number of columns in the second matrix, which means this product will be a 1x2 matrix. Now we can go ahead and find the elements in each position. Notice this first element would be in row 1, column 1, and to find this element, we'll always use a row from the first matrix and a column from the second matrix. So again, to find the element in row 1, column 1, we'll find the product of row 1 from the first matrix and column 1 from the second matrix. To multiply a row and a column, we're going to find the product of the first elements, then the product of the second elements, and then find the sum. So we would have negative 3 times negative 4 plus positive 7 times negative 5. Well, this would be positive 12 plus negative 35, which is equal to negative 23. So the element in row 1, column 1 of our product is negative 23. And now we're left to find the element in row 1, column 2, or a sub 1, comma 2, which means now we'll find the product of row 1 from the first matrix and column 2 from the second matrix. So now we're going to have negative 3 times positive 3 plus positive 7 times positive 2. So we'll have negative 9 plus 14, which is equal to positive 5. So matrix D times matrix C is equal to this 1x2 matrix. I hope you found this example helpful. We'll take a look at some additional examples in the next few videos, but I'll leave you now with some more formal notes on matrix multiplication. I hope you found this helpful.